on this election day, can I remind you of something that we talked about a while back? That's on the David Perdue election side. So he's running against Jon Ossoff. Jon Ossoff, if you didn't know, is Jewish. You may not have known that, but you know who did know that? David Perdue's campaign. And I know that because they decided to do this ad. This is a little blast from the past for you. Breaking: Schumer spending $3 million in Georgia for Jon Ossoff. Democrats are trying to buy Georgia. So if you're looking at this picture, you may not get what the issue is. But what you don't realize is that they have decided to artificially make Jon Ossoff's nose bigger in that. So let's go to this next photo and you'll see the direct comparison.
Right.
They made his nose bigger. And here's the thing. They tried to pretend that this was like just a graphical glitch, a little issue. And you know, if you do Photoshop, you might think, well, you know, they were like selecting his head and they selected too much so they got the background. But that's not the case, because the background around his nose is black. They added more nose to the nose, not a black border around the nose. They added nose to a Jewish candidate, then threw him up with another Jewish candidate and said that they're trying to buy the state. Look, if you don't get this or what they're playing into, my sweet summer child, you need to wake up to what America is, because whether it's left-wing and the candidate's black, so they're trying to scare people about black candidates. This guy happens to be Jewish, so they're trying to play in anti-Semitic stereotypes. But on both sides of this race, it is absolutely dirty.
Dirty. And for them to deny, I mean, they're never gonna cop to it, right? They're never gonna cop to it. But no. Again, visually, John, those are all incredibly salient points that you make about Photoshop, the editing, and the what that would take to have that picture be rendered that way. They absolutely intentionally made it that way, right? And that's because, going back to the people who were voting, the people they want to appeal to, that's how they view those people. That's how they, that's what they think of those people. They think that all people that are Jewish or Israeli or of that faith look that way, right? They have these noses, or any kind of stereotype that they've grown up with or that they bought into, they believe that to be true. I mean, there's no need for, the noses are similar, but they added at least half a nose or half a nose point. I'm looking at it right now to his nose purposely, intentionally, right? So, and like going back to Loeffler's picture, for what purpose did they need to darken the photo? We know who the person was in the photo. What would be the reasoning for that? There's no reason to make those changes at all. No legitimate reason, right? It's all intentional, it's all purposeful, and it's all wrong. And so, you know, but again, in 2021 and everything we saw in 2020, John, are you shocked? Guys watching at home, are you shocked?
No, we do have to point it out. And you know, whether the individual person that they had do this thinks of themselves as a racist or whatever, whether Kelly Loeffler thinks or Perdue think of themselves as racist or anti-Semitic, they clearly believe that the path to getting elected is appealing to voters that are gonna like this stuff. They're gonna be scared by a darker skinned black candidate. They're gonna like the idea of this, like, this Jewish candidate coming in and buying things up in a scheme. Like, whether they personally believe it, they think that that is what their base is. And so that's what they're giving them.
And they think that's what their base is, based on probably, John, what their base has told them. Conversations or data collected, or things that they found out from their base that would lead them to that. Because people, when you have, I would imagine that when you have a campaign, your goal is to win, right? And so you hire people, you enact all these different tools for that purpose. And some of those tools are to gather data to give the people what they want. Case in point, Trump's rally, giving the people what they want. That base wants to hear that rhetoric. So when you have these types of egregious and disgusting pictures, it's probably coming from a source that says, hey, this is how we really feel about those things. This is how we really feel about those people. This is how we view those people and how they move through the world, I would imagine.
Yeah, I think so. And we're gonna do it as a full clip. We don't have time because we got other stuff that I wanna move on to. But I did wanna let you know a bit of good news for Kelly Loeffler, you know, on the eve of her trying to get reelected. She's a billionaire now. She was already incredibly wealthy, the wealthiest senator. her husband and her together were worth like over $800 million. Well, you know how like all those like billionaires were making tons of money during the pandemic? He was one of them. And so they are now worth more than $1 billion. That's nice for her. That's very nice for her. Good news for such a good person. I'm sure they earned it.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.